The world is beautiful.
دشه لونی اقامت اپاره نداشم
دشه شه خودی چه چوله بو خودی شده تو بچه دی می چه چوله چی ده چه توش شده تو می شده
دشه همی
کنگوله خودی می کنگه خلو دیدو شده بگو
Juan Jean-Dorie Pinot, Jamie Kato, そしてDuncan Bridgman です. Welcome to Japan. Tell us, how and why did you start One Giant Leap?
You do how I do why.
We're musicians.
The way we make our album is we take our backing tracks to the most inspiring musicians we can find.
We have a process. What we do is we give them our beat, they add their music and sing their song. This is from every country across the world, with people just hearing in the headphones what the last person did.
Can I explain that very well?
So I thought it was brilliant. No, I thought it was brilliant.
Okay, ready? Rolling.
As well as going around the world looking for amazing musicians, we went to look for amazing inspirational people to talk to about big subjects of life.
We are searching for truth in many countries.
About God, sex,
anger,
love,
freedom,
conflict,
madness,
loneliness,
death,
anger.
Did I say anger twice?
10 years ago, you couldn't have done what we've done. Basically, we record on a laptop, we film on a DV camera, which means that we can slip in kind of undetected, and it's like a kind of guerrilla way of making films.
You're not in control. You're not in control of yourself, and you're not in control of what you're going to get. You are in control. No, you're not in control.
It's like a string of consciousness, and then you have all these beats of music.
And then when you weave it all together,
all the music and all the philosophy, after a while, it just fits.
This is two guys, you know, going around the world looking for the aliveness, for the gifts that just come out of nowhere.
And when we wove together all the diverse people, we ended up with One Giant Leap.
We were about to set off on a 6-month journey of a lifetime, taking our laptops and recording equipment around the world. It was a huge challenge to get everything ready and say goodbye to everyday life.
We didn't know what to expect on this trip. We felt like explorers setting off on a unique treasure hunt. There was no script to fall back on. It was down to us to find the jewels.
Another day of intrepid outing around Cairo.
Cairo.
Ah! We're doing oud today. He's a funky oud player. Play me Okay, so psychedelic overdub number 1.
Everything starts with a simple riff picked up by musicians around the world. From the funky oud in Egypt, to a voice in Brazil, to a flute in India. And the theme for this track, how come it's so hard to find peace in the modern world?
I guess it's because we get bombarded and bombarded and bombarded with the images so many times that our brain loses the ability to react to them. Earthquakes end. Storms come to an end. The media never shuts off. You can't get away from it.
They give us daily newspapers, the 6 o'clock news, pronouncements by politicians, government policies, comms, advertising. And none of it bears much resemblance at all to what's really going on in the universe. And when's the last time you heard anyone complain?
I think that TV is an emanation of this, the triumph of the blasé. I want to say I think it's a disgrace. How can the blasé be triumphing so? They can't possibly have a good army. I mean, they're blasé. They're not known for their gung-ho. but they're kicking ass right now. The blasé are kicking ass.
And we're off to meet Maxi Jazz today, thank God. We've been chasing him for a bit. We're going to film it in his studio. And he just sent me a text. He said, you come at 1:30, I've got some chanting to finish. Not work to finish or, you know, books to read. And he's like, I've got some chanting to finish. And then the text came through straight after that and he said, What am I saying? Come and do the chanting with me. Here it is, there we go, with the Buddha outside.
As one of the world's top rappers and a practicing Buddhist, we knew Maxi would have some great ideas to contribute on how to deal with the bombardment of the modern world. Pity I didn't really know how to work his studio.
Umbadang, I can tell by the way. Can you get the track up a bit? I love to watch us be rich.
Sorry, Max, I haven't got it. You're not coming through.
2, 2, 1. Yeah. Oh, I got it now, I got you.
Your hips do what? Why you keep messing with it while I'm in the middle of my thing?
No, I'm sorry.
I used to talk more than I used to listen. Now I reverse my position. Now I can start with precision. Those on a mission and those who love me, the dissing of those who seem to suppose they govern me. I'm pretty, the ugly, the unlovely. Can no longer hope to escape, discover, become. All of them lack subtlety and none of them have no real quality.
La forma cruel de hacerlo es partir de necesidades en base a tus miedos. Si la señora dice, no quiero que mi esposo me vea que me salió una arruga, entonces ese insight es muy probable que lo puedas tomar y lo metes dentro del comercial. Alguien está poniéndose crema, llega el esposo, le da un beso y ella está feliz porque no se dio cuenta de que tiene una arruga. Es como mantener lejos de su propio poder a la mujer. ¿Por qué? Porque si tuviera poder, no te creería nada de los comerciales.
Sombo de vidro, estrela de papel, poeira virou o céu da estrela dela. Mi navi, estrela amarela, que brilha o dia todo, mostrou que era ouro de arco-íris.
Here we are with Noam Chomsky talking about the powers that be and how the masses are controlled and all the things he's an expert on. I just feel incredibly grateful for this and all the other times that we just get to hang with these people who don't really know who we are or what we're doing.
I got you this present.
Oh, thanks.
I know you don't have enough to read.
Sure, it's my real problem.
And we have huge propaganda systems. Public relations industry is fundamentally a propaganda system. It's an enormous industry. Developed first in Britain and the United States. These are the two countries that were most free and democratic. And that's where you need a propaganda system. Because there, you can't control people by force anymore. So you have to control their beliefs and attitudes. And this is very conscious. The core of democracy is the engineering of consent. And you're directed, you know, by the educational system, by the media, to have the aspiration of becoming a millionaire. And then if you don't quite make it, you didn't meet your aspiration. But there are other values, you know. There's another value to say, okay, I won't be a millionaire, but I'll help people who really need help. And you don't have to go to Ethiopia to find this. You can do it right in the United States.
I open myself completely to you. My intention is the deepest, true, true love. How can I be a better lover to you? How can I be a better brother to you? How can I be a better father to you? How can I be a better friend to you? How can I be? How can I be? Beep, 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 beep. Is that message? Can you hear my message?
How can I be a better sister? How can I be a better human? Human, human.
There'll be a dozen letters from young people in Canada and the United States and England and so on, saying, you know, I don't like what's going on, what can I do? Interestingly, I never get that question from people in poor countries. They don't ask me what they should do, they tell me what they're doing. And that's part of our education and indoctrination, to make you feel there is nothing you can do. But you can do a lot. In fact, you can do anything.
By the time we got to India, every country had started to look the same.
Everyone had a mobile phone. It's the same shops, the same adverts. You could get a cappuccino on every corner. How far do you have to go before you get away from the bombardment?
We've come a very long way on a very long train and a very long flight to visit the bowels of Bengal in West Bengal in Shantinikatan, which I can say as many times as you like perfectly.
Shantinikatan. We think we've made a discovery of a new cosmic law. When people are really good and really friendly and really nice and they reach a certain attainment of being able to deal with the world and the people around them, when they die, they're reincarnated and sent to Shantinikatan.
Good morning. Good morning.
We're on the edge. There is electricity here and there's a few TVs and a couple of cars, but basically it's kind of still out there.
My name is Sonia Dalbarago.
Hello.
Hello.
Everybody's really happy. And I know that probably sounds really stupid to say that people with nothing are happier, but I don't know, I think there might be. I think when you get a lot, you get greedy and you want more and you're never happy. Just experiment.
Hey.
Stay, please, again, one more, yes. While the spirit is here.
No problem, okay. The spirit now just comes.
A better guy, I wonder why.
Although we've been to some of the most beautiful places on the planet, far away from the bombardment of adverts and the noise of the modern world, the stress of being away and on tour was always still present. Even when everything around is quiet, there's always the noise of thoughts rattling around your brain. We dedicated the second part of our track to facing up to our demons and finding peace within ourselves.
We have to snap out of it. We have to figure out, how do I find peace of mind? How do I find that place inside of me where I can stop listening to this inner noise and start really listening?
Today is a big day. Today is the day we go to see Michael Stipe.
Do you think we're nervous? Do we appear nervous? It's a big day.
What came out of our search for Michael was not only the song, but also an understanding of what was going into our film as a reflection of what was going on for us at the time.
I have seen trouble, trouble saw me. I danced around the trouble tree. I have seen beauty staggered on me. I've seen trouble.
So we're going to see the Bone Cycle, which is Gabrielle Roth's workshop. She's got about 50 people in there, and we're going to do some shooting and some chatting and some jumping about.
He's going to do jumping about. I'm going to watch.
You excited?
I'm so fucking excited.
We're doing the angry dance. And as soon as you get this started, then just begin to let it go and begin to feel these different shapes.
I've held my heart so close to my chest. You leave me wanting, I can't forget now.
Suddenly when I'm in there, like, I know Gabrielle really wants me to dance because I never do.
the more I kind of am in there and think about doing it, the more my bones feel so heavy and I feel tired and I just feel drained of energy. I feel so blocked with dancing, so blocked. It must prove that I'm just so not in my body at all. Duncan got straight into that. Just look at all of them and I think it would be wonderful to feel that free, to just really let it go.
Ultimately, it's your own mind which creates this fear, and then your own mind tries to solve it, and it is not possible to solve it at the level of the mind.
What was the reason of the workshop?
I guess it's improvisation.
Yeah.
So each person finds his own sound. Make music without instruments.
Ow!
And try to...
One of the big subjects of our film is communication. We want to talk more about the communication in here, inner communication. Mm.
Is your inner critic under control?
You have all of this chatter that you have to kind of clear out, you know what I mean? Parents, your aunts, your grandmama's voice, everybody's voice is in your head. So it gets to a point where, well, where is my voice? Who is this to realize? Like, internal dialogue?
Yeah, I mean, it's the Greek chorus thing, isn't it? You are a twat. But right now I could be talking and that other part of me is going, you don't believe that for a second. It just might sound, you think it sounds good to say that.
This ego character is coming on. He's taking over my mouth. He's taking over my phone. He's driving my car.
Stop, pump the brakes. So it's just a switch in the internal tape and weeding out all of that external and historical static.
There's no way out. We are all stuck in our minds.
Stop. Be here now. Be in this moment. We're always past future, past future, past future. We keep missing the now. And all we have is the now.
We visited a Sufi whirling dervish group who used the Rumi-inspired spinning to quieten their minds and tune into what they call the greater perfection.
I think one of the common misunderstandings about meditation is that there is... The goal, if you like, is that you empty your mind and you become very still and there is this void, you know. In a way, I don't like that idea. I think that idea actually gives you the wrong angle, you know. Actually, what happens when you sit in meditation is you feel very, very uncomfortable. You know, your mind's going crazy. It's like it's trapped in a cage and it wants to get out and it's running around looking for a way out. And you don't want to be there. You want to be down the pub or watching television or doing anything, but you don't want to be there looking at this wall, you know. So it is uncomfortable and it should be uncomfortable. That's the process. It's like it's your ability to stay with that, to actually begin to explore a very simple question in a way. Why is it uncomfortable? Why is it so uncomfortable to be still?
We are about to go and meet Eckhart Tolle, which is about the most exciting thing that's happened to me all week. Eckhart Tolle is the guy that wrote The Power of Now, and it's like a handbook to your brain.
Hi, Eckhart, Jamie.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Thanks a lot for coming.
It says, look, there's your brain. Look at yourself thinking. Look at how unhappy you're making yourself, you mad person. and then it gives you some ideas on how to sort of get your brain under control.
To appreciate the present moment, there needs to be a gap in the stream of compulsive noise making, which is called thinking, most of which is unnecessary, some of it is useful, but most of it actually interferes with the smooth flow of life. It creates so much suffering, so many problems that actually have no existence here and now.
I have some trouble, trouble saw me. I danced around the trouble tree.
Eckhart's words rung true for us both. It was time to stop worrying and get on with making some music.
I play you a track.
Yeah.
And when there's something that works, so this is the kind of thing that will work.
Nice one.
And we'll go on that one, and we'll maybe do a marimba and a vocals and some stuff and build it.
Okay.
When we hooked up with Will Young to finish the song, we wanted to write a lyric that expressed the need to find a place of peace and feel the joy of the moment.
Love that is nice.
Stillness is already here. It's an essential part of who you are. And all you need to do is get in touch with that. How do I get in touch with that? The easiest way is to become friendly with the present moment. This is it. This is it. It's always going to be this. And this is who you are. And to sense that is joyful. And that joy is not through anything external. It's inherent.
Communicating lively but without a sound. This is what makes my world go round.